class. Right. So let us start. I think I have taken your power supply system class, is not it?
Yes, ma'am.
Not the power system planning and design. I have taken a section.
And, yes, ma'am. Not the planning and design.
And for this assignment part, we are totally fed up with those. So if whatever I have instructed to the students to do, they have not done. Actually, they have not even gone through the instructions. Whatever file name we have instructed to do, everyone, there are some students, we have given all the assignments in the same name, with name and roll number only. So it is very difficult to open all the 12 emails for that particular student and find out my answer scripts. And if they have not sent, some of you have not sent the answer scripts to my email ID also. I have not taken your class in last semester, but in power supply system I have taken. So do not do that one, that thing. You must follow the instructions regarding file name, regarding email ID, and submit your paper at the time. Okay. This time I have considered, I think, four students in your class. I have to repeatedly knock, and then I have to collect the answer scripts from there. Okay, so do not do that one. I shall not entertain this thing for this power system performance if it is going off for online examination. If it is offline, then it is fine. But for online examination, I shall not allow anybody to, without proper file name or without a late, you have forgotten to submit personally and in the common email ID, I shall not allow. In common email ID, you should give your name, your subject name properly. It is repeatedly written in the instruction, but you have not given. You have just written your name and roll number. Okay. And there are so many people, 12 into your class strength is the answer scripts available in the common email ID. So you can find, you can think that how much it is difficult to find out all those answer scripts there. So be very sincere about that, or at least for this particular session. Anyway, let me start. I think I have not taught you the power system planning and design, so I need some points that I discussed at the first class of power system planning and design to brush up some idea that is very much required for power system performance class, that I shall brush up at first, then I shall go to the main topic. And just I want to make you aware that this power supply, power system performance class is the most difficult or most lengthy, is of most lengthy syllabus among those all the power classes have you gone through right now. So be sincere about this, and this is a very conceptual class also, only recording or the PPT is not sufficient. You have to go to the book, and if you have to go to the content time to time to clear your idea. Right, it is required for your higher studies, your examination, your job interviews, and general viva voce examination in fourth year first semester. So go through this paper very sincerely. In third year second semester, actually all the papers are very important for third year second semester. This is the main course of electrical engineering are there. So being sincere for this part, let me start. And if the slides are not changing, then you must tell me, okay, at first. Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So at first, so regarding file name, all these things I have told you. This performance calculation part of power transmission line, you have already done in your power system planning and design class. So there we need to calculate the power. So power calculation, we know this, active power is VI cos phi. For three phase system, roots to VLIL cos phi. and reactive power is root 3 VLIL sin phi. There is no issue on that. But in that case, we assume that we know the power angle or phase difference between voltage and current for which you are calculating power. But it may not happen when there is an interconnected large power system, then we may need to calculate it through computer. So there it may not happen that your voltage is the reference phasor for the current. Because when you are calculating the power using a formula root 3 VLIL cos phi or 3 VPIP cos phi, in that case you know that phi is the power as the angle of current with respect to the voltage. So voltage is the reference phasor, but it may not happen. So we shall know the basic conception. You know, for lagging load always we use equation S equal to VI conjugate. If we use equation VI conjugate, then inductive var will be positive. Now at first, why we should consider conjugate, not only I? Because if we consider only I, then in phase component of then some active power will be missing. So we need to go for the conjugate. One thing, let me see whether I have an example or not. So for this particular example, if this is voltage, this is current, voltage is not the reference phasor, reference is somewhat something else. With respect to that, you know the voltage is at a beta at an angle alpha and current is at an angle beta. Can you see the slide?
No, ma'am.
Huh?
Yes, no, ma'am.
The one phasor diagram showing the voltage under consideration.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
No.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am, it is stuck on the first slide. Yes, ma'am, it has come now.
Why every time it is stuck only the first time?
Ma'am, it is visible now.
Okay, every time it is happening. In last class also I have seen the same, facing the same problem. Anyway, so here you can see, here voltage is shown by red color, current is shown by purple color. So voltage is leading from the reference by an angle alpha. If you cannot follow me, then you must ask me. And current is leading from the reference by an angle beta. So actually angle between voltage and current is alpha minus beta, that is phi. But it is available, this information is available to you when you are drawing the phasor diagram or you are handling the voltage and current value separately. But when you are doing a computer calculation, then always you will get the voltage at an angle alpha, current at an angle beta. So you have to derive phi from there every time. So for that reason, always the use of equation VI conjugate or V conjugate I is better. So here, what will be the active power? You can calculate using your basic conception VI cos phi. But in short, active power always the summation of product of in-phase component of voltage and current. Because you know, resistive power is the active power. Power through a resistance is the active power. So what is the relation between the phase difference between voltage and current in resistance? Zero. So here V1, I1 are in same phase. So product of V1, I1 will give you the active power. At the same time, V2, I2 are also in same phase. What is V2, I2? The quadrature component of voltage and current. And what is V1, I1? The real component of voltage and current. So product of V1, I1 as well as product of V2, I2 will give you the active power. If you take the V into I only, then you will miss this one as the active power component. You try it yourself. So actually here active power will be V1, I1 plus V2, I2. Similarly, you know, for inductive load, current is lagging from the voltage. For capacitive load, current is leading from the voltage. So always leading by 90 degree or lagging by 90 degree. So always the voltage and current are at 90 degree out of phase for the reactive power. So here also, if you see current voltage V1, current I2, then I2 current is leading from the voltage V1 by 90 degree. So it will produce a capacitive reactive var or capacitive var. Similarly, the current I1 is lagging voltage V2 by an angle 90 degrees. So it will produce an inductive reactive var. So inductive and capacitive reactive var are of different sense. So if you put one positive, another should be negative. So if we put inductive var as positive, so we must put V2 I1 as positive. Why V2 I1 positive? Because V2 I1 is lagging 90 degrees from V2. So V2 I1 is the inductive var. Similarly, V1 I2 is the capacitive var, so it will be negative. So this, the total summation of this, if this comes positive, that means it is inductive. It is coming negative, that means it is capacitive. So you know the value. Now, if you put the value by some numerical calculation, say it is giving 0.8 VAR. That means it is 0.8 VAR inductive. If it is giving minus 0.8 VAR, that means minus 0.8 VAR inductive. That actually means 0.8 VAR capacitive. And active power is always means the what, right? So resistive load. So for that reason, always we take in conjugate to get all the all the active power accordingly, and VI conjugate or V conjugate I, we can use both the thing. In all the cases, if we take any one of the voltage or current conjugate, then we'll take active power properly. But for VI conjugate, we shall get inductive var as positive. For V conjugate I, we shall get capacitive var as positive. You have gone through all these things in basic electrical, but I am going through this one for my own interest. Has the slide changed?
No, ma'am.
Every time.
Now it is.
So actually, let us come to the previous slide again. So for lag load, we always take VI conjugate. Actually, for lagging current, the I is at an angle minus phi. So if we take phi conjugate, then obviously we take plus phi. So we shall take positive in the positive imaginary part. Positive imaginary part of the power. So that means if we take VI conjugate, then we shall get inductive var positive. Similarly, for this case, capacitive var will come negative. Similarly, for leading load, we always, if we want to calculate leading load as positive, leading var as positive, then we shall conjugate the V, because V is lagging. So if we make V conjugate, then we shall get the positive part. So in brief, when we do the power calculation, we have to do either conjugate of voltage or current. Otherwise, we shall not get the active power calculation will not be right. Second thing, we have to identify whatever the power, reactive power is coming after calculation, whether it is inductive or capacitive, by which logic we shall do that one. If we have used VI conjugate, then inductive power will come as positive. If we using VI conjugate, capacitive power will come as negative, and the reverse for the V conjugate I. For power system calculation, we always use VI conjugate, because in power system, most of the loads are inductive. So if we use VI conjugate, then most of the induct var will come positive, because most of the var, volt ampere reactive or reactive power will be inductive power. So for that reason, we always consider VI conjugate, generally consider VI conjugate to calculate power in power system calculation. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So these are the fundamental, actually, which may need this one in future. So use this. So you try to calculate this one using VI conjugate. So in that case, you take V equal to V1 plus JV2, I equal to I1 plus JI2, and just calculate this thing. Now the first class is on power unit system. What is the need of power unit system? What is power unit system? Power unit system is actually one type of representation. So you know that we represent voltage by V, volt, kV, millivolt. This is a unit of voltage.
Similarly, no, slide has not changed.
Slide has not changed. Today it is happening. I do not know why, how to solve this problem.
That's the problem.
Every time I have to close and open it. Anyway, so every unit or every component of power system has its own unit. Say for generator voltage, for transformer, there is reactance in ohm or say resistance in ohm, then the voltage level in kV. And at the same time, for power system, throughout the, I hope you know this is the single line diagram of a power system. So for this, at every point, there is a change in voltage and current level. If you see the primary side of this transformer T1, then the voltage level is 11 kV. For the secondary side of transformer T2, voltage level is 132 kV for this transmission line. Now, if there be any change in generating voltage, then there will be total change in transmission line voltage as well as at the voltage level at the receiving end that is received by the motor. So if we want to solve this circuit, because we have to assess the performance of transmission line or power system, then we have to calculate voltage current at every level. So every time you have to remember at which point you are calculating. See, if you are calculating at any point in between this transmission line, then voltage level will be within 132 kV. It will be somewhat less than 132 kV because there will be some line drop, all those. Similarly, for the generator and transformer T1 side, the voltage, maximum voltage will be 11 kV. Similarly, T2 to motor side, voltage will be 33 kV. So every time, the voltage level is abruptly changing. And for the for the constant power, current is also changing. So for that reason, it is very difficult, the calculation become very difficult. We have to find out some easy way of representation so that we can avoid this voltage change. Voltage change we cannot avoid. We shall represent the transmission system in such a way that we can tackle this voltage change in a very efficient way. That is the per unit system. So instead of this voltage, ohm, current, we shall represent everything, voltage, current, impedance, admittance, everything in terms of per unit. So per unit is actually an unit or a one sort of representation. It is not a unit, it is a one sort of representation. For example, say in your class, say one student has got 400 out of 500. Then you can calculate percentage of marks obtained by that student. But you cannot assess what is the position of that student in your class. Okay. So if then in that case, we use the percentile or all those things. And by percentage, you can assess how much marks he has got out of 100. So in that way, you can assess his performance. But if it is, say, only if you say the marks, 400, then you cannot assess anything. Out of 400, out of what? 1,000, 10,000, or 500. So in that way, it can be represented. If you represent in a percent, then it will be more useful, more meaningful. So in that way, per unit also, that type of thing, we shall represent in terms of percentage or per unit. Generally, here I shall discuss about per unit, but per unit is similar to the percentage. Say, what is per unit value of anything? Actual value of the quantity by base value of the same quantity. What is the meaning of base value? Base value will be decided by us. Who is tackling that one? Who are deciding, calculating the per unit value? Say for 11 kV system, we can take 11 kV as the base value. Why? Because if we take for 11 kV system, if we take 11 kV as the base value, then actual, if the actual quantity is 11 kV and base quantity is 11 kV, then the per unit value will be 1. That means it is 100%. It is ideal condition. But if you take the base value as 1,000, then you cannot assess the where is the system lying. But so always we take rated quantity as the base quantity. Say IA, VV, Z, say dohom, V are the actual values. Actual values means I in ampere, V means voltage, Z in ohm, S in volt ampere, S means apparent power in volt ampere are the actual quantities. That means what is the actual quantities of the power system? And IB, VB, B means base quantities, ZB, SB are the base values. Then in power unit, current in power unit will be actual by base, voltage in power unit is actual by base, similarly impedance and power. So actually power unit value is nothing but the ratio, but it has several advantages. Similarly, Z power unit is Z ohm by ZB. Now Z power unit is the R power unit plus Jx power unit. Obviously it will have a complex, it will be a complex number. Then R power unit is not R ohm by R base. R power unit is the R ohm by Z base. X power unit is the X ohm by X base, Z base. Similarly for power also, S power unit is the P power unit plus J power unit. But S volt ampere is P plus JQ. So actually P power unit is the P by SB and Q by SB. Have you, can you follow me? Can you see the slide?
Ma'am, which slide?
This power unit.
What's the heading?
Huh?
What's the heading of the slide?
Ma'am, it is still at the slide of the need per unit system.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Now it's seen.
Same time also, I am forgetting. And what I have told, that is in vain. Power unit value is the actual value of the quantity by base value of the same quantity. So IA, VB, Z ohm, Z ohm, if these are the actual value and these are the base value, then for current, voltage, impedance or power, if you divide actual value by the base value, then we shall get the power unit value. Okay. Now say for voltage, for this particular voltage, can you see the slide?
Yes, ma'am.
So for voltage, always we take base quantity, but for any quantity, always we take the base quantity near to the rated one, so that the ratio come near to the one, so that we can assess that what is the present condition of the system. Say for if you are representing a voltage, their voltage is expected to be 11 kV and you are getting 11 kV, then that in power unit will be 11 by 11, one power unit. So in that case, you can, from the value, you can assess that the system is healthy. Okay. And if the voltage is 5 kV only instead of 11 kV, then the voltage is near less than 0.2 power unit. So in that case, I think 0.5 power unit. So in that case, you can assess that the system is very unhealthy in that case. So from the power unit value, we can assess that what is the condition of the system. But for impedance is Z is equal to R plus Jx. Now this impedance Z ohm, we can write R plus Jx ohm. I have not shown the here. You can do it yourself. Then obviously, if we represent this Z ohm by R plus Jx, then R power unit will be R by ZB, not R by RB. Similarly, X is X by ZB, not X by XB. Right? Similarly, for power, we have calculated power as S by SB. Now, this power is actually P plus JQ, right?
Yes, sir.
So, actually, this P power unit would be then P by SB and Q power unit would be Q by SB, not P by PB. There is no base value of separately active power and reactive power. Base value is always for apparent power. So active power will be the actual active power by base value of apparent power, and reactive power will be the permanent reactive power will be the actual reactive power by the base value of the apparent power. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see the slide for single phase system?
Yes, ma'am.
For single phase system, what will be impedance? Voltage by current? What is the power? SB equal to VVIB conjugate. VVIB. I have told you power is VVIB conjugate. But for the base quantity, it is VVIB because there is no power factor there. Okay, so you do not use generally VVIB conjugate because these are the rated quantities, some reference value. Generally, volt ampere and voltages are specified as base quantities. We have no need to specify all the things as base quantity, impedance, current, all those things, because those things we can derive from the apparent power and the voltage. So generally, it is sufficient to select the base volt ampere and base impedance. Other thing, we can both base volt ampere and base voltage. From there, you can derive current, impedance, admittance, everything. Now, base current is IB equal to SB by VB. So, base current IB equal to SB by VB. Then, base impedance is VB by IB. So, IB we can replace by SB by VB. So, finally, Z become VB square by SB. So, we can derive actually ZB in terms of VBSB. We have no need to specify ZB differently. Have you understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
So actually, we need in power system, we need actually voltage and impedance maximum. So voltage, we generally directly assume base voltage, and base impedance we can calculate using base power and the base apparent power and the base voltage. We have no need to separately assume the base impedance. Similarly, base admittance we can also calculate, but it does not have so much use. We can do it using base impedance also. If we can get the the permanent impedance, then obviously 1 upon that will be the permanent admittance. We have no need to calculate admittance separately, but still you can calculate it, that you can derive the formula for that. Remember that permanent value has no specified unit. Their unit is per unit, but all base values have specified unit. The base value, selecting some rated value. So for voltage, it will be kV or megavolt. For current, ampere. For impedance, ohm. But for permanent quantity, all are in permanent. There is no other thing. For voltage calculation, KVL is always valid. So V permanent equal to Z into I. So for any loop, for any closed loop. Similarly, for power calculation, S equal to VI conjugate. This is also valid. It is in per unit, not for the base quantities. For base quantities, we do not take any conjugate because that is not required. There is no power factor specified. It is a general case, so it is VVIB only. Then for star connection, what will happen? Say for star connection, there is base phase quantities as well as line quantities. So let us assume the line quantities as base value as VLB. Then what will be its relation with the phase quantities? Obviously, line voltage is root 3 into phase voltage. So that will be valid for the base quantities also. And line current equal to phase current, so that will be applicable to base quantities also. And for actual quantities also, VL equal to VP root 3, IL equal to IP for star connection. Then what will happen to permanent calculation? So if we calculate permanent value of line voltage, then actual line voltage by the base voltage of base value of line voltage. Now, actual line voltage is Vp into root 3. Similarly, the base value of line voltage is Vpb into root 3. Then obviously, the VL per unit is coming similar equal to Vp per unit, because Vp per unit is Vp by Vpb. So actually, line quantity and phase quantity will be same in per unit. So this is the advantage. You have no need to bother about star connection or delta connection or whether it is line quantity or phase quantity. Say in line quantity, you are getting a voltage of 0.9 per unit. Say for a 400 kV system, 0.9 per unit is the voltage. Then in line value, the voltage will be 0.9 into 400. For base, for the phase quantity, the voltage will be 0.9 into 400 by root 3. So just your base, the base values will be changed, but the per unit values will be same. Can you, could you follow me?
Yes, ma'am.
This class is from 1 p.m. I have just one consecutive class before this of second year, so I will be late 5 to 10 minutes because I have to shift all these things. Otherwise, I shall not allow anybody after 1:15 p.m. because it is very much disturbing to come every time and I have to close my presentation and just give them entry. In my actual class, I never give entry after I enter in the classroom, right? You have seen that one. And you are repeatedly doing this thing on the virtual class. Okay, I shall not allow. So from the next class, you come in time. Do not do this thing. At 1:30:59, Rupoy to do, I shall not allow you. There is not so much internet problem as far I know. Communicate my point to your all of your classmates. I shall not allow anybody after 15 minutes of the class from the next class. Maximum 15 minutes. It is very much disturbing. So for per unit quantity also, for line, for current also, you will get the same thing. So actually, what is the point? What is the main advantage of per unit value? That whatever calculation you are doing, whatever value you are getting, you have no need to bother about the phase quantity or line quantity. You have no need of any conversion. Whatever you are getting from there, if you want to get the actual quantity in phase values, you multiply it by base quantity of phase value. If you want to get actual quantity in line values, then you multiply it by base quantity of my line values. So this is the advantage. Otherwise, in practical case, every time you have to think about the connection, whether it is star or delta, accordingly you have to convert it into phase quantity or phase values or line values. Same derivation, VL per unit equal to VB per unit, IL per unit equal to IB per unit, you derive it for delta connection. This is the simplest part of this syllabus, and I have this last year I have not got a very good answer from this topic. I do not know why. Then power calculation, you know, for both star and delta connection, we can write three phase power equal to root 3 VLIL or 3 VPIP, right? Here it will be conjugate. I have forgotten this one here. 1 minute, let me correct. So what I want to say here, when you are calculating actual power, you must take conjugate because it has some phase angles, I do not know what. But for base quantities, you are taking some values, say 50 kilowatt, 50 MVA power, 30 kilowatt, 30 kV voltage. So for in there is no power factor. So there is no question of conjugate. But in actual calculation, obviously there will be current conjugate. Then if we want to calculate power in per unit, if we go with the line quantities, because power we can calculate using line quantities as well as phase quantities, then obviously VL by VLB will give you the line voltage in per unit. and IL star by ILB will give you line voltage in power unit of conjugate of that. Similarly, if we proceed with the phase quantities, we will get give the VI conjugate in terms of phase voltage in power unit. And we have already seen the line voltage or voltage in power unit is independent of line quantity or phase quantity. So actually these two permanent values will be same. So only the calculation will be VI conjugate, V power unit, I power unit conjugate, nothing more than that. So say for it, for the easier example, I am telling you, say this is a 300 kVA system, right? Then you are getting this apparent power as 0.8 plus j 0.4, and let me write. See, you are getting by calculation this power 0.8 plus 0.8 plus j 0.4 per unit.
Then,
what happened?
We are not the same slide. Uh-huh. I mean, we are lagging. Now it's visible.
So for star delta connection, actually the US prompt me because I am not accustomed with this. Every time it is happening for today. Okay. Then three phase power is 3 VI conjugate in terms of root 3 VLIL conjugate or 3 VPIP conjugate. And base quantities, there is no conjugate part because this is the actually you are assuming some value. You are not assuming any power factor. So you are assuming say 500 kVA system and 33 kV system. So there is no power factor. So you cannot get this one. It is not required also. So if we want to calculate per unit power, then three phase power, actual quantity by base quantity. Now this three phase power may be in terms of line quantity or base phase quantity. Now, if we replace in terms of line quantity, then it will be for actual root 3 VLIL conjugate, for the base root 3 VLB ILB. So VL by VLB will give you the VL in per unit. IL by ILB will be give you IL in per unit. Similarly, three phase power at the same time, you can calculate using VPIP conjugate in terms of phase quantity. Similarly, the actual base value also you can calculate using, you can represent using the phase quantities 3 VPB IPB. So from there we will get power either in VI conjugate in terms of per unit of phase quantities or power equal to VI conjugate in per unit in terms of line quantities. But in both the cases you have seen previously, can you see this slide?
No, ma'am.
You cannot see. It is stuck.
Yes, ma'am. It's stuck on the previous slide.
I do not know how to solve this problem. I cannot see. Anyway, leave it. If for the star connection, we have seen that the line quantities or phase quantities are same, right? The line quantities and phase quantities are same for voltage and as well as current, right? Then here we are getting, can you see this slide, power?
Yes, ma'am.
Then per unit is the VLIL conjugate and power is again VPIP conjugate. Both are in per unit. Now these values are same. VL per unit and VP per unit numerical values are same. IL per unit or IP per unit numerical values are same. So with that, if you get some value 0.8 plus j 0.4, say the power, the base power is say 300 MVA, right? These are 300 MVA. When I am saying this is the base power, that means this is the line quantity. That means if we want to calculate total power, then active power will be 0.8 into 300, that means 240 megawatt. And reactive power will be 0.4 into 300, that means 120 MVAR. Have you understood? because this is the permanent value. If you want to get actual value, you have to multiply it by base quantity. Can you follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, if now you are getting the permanent power as 0.8 plus J0.4. Now, say if you want to calculate per phase power, then what will be the per phase power? In this is the line quantity, then phase quantity obviously will be 100, right? L by, because power is, per phase power is divided by 3. Then per phase, it will be 80 and it will be 40, as simple as that.
Yes, ma'am.
So in this way, it is easier to calculate, easier to represent the per unit quantities. Next is base impedance. Impedance is always be some phase quantity, will never be a line quantity. So obviously phase impedance is V by I. So V by I we can write S by V. So from there V square by SB. We have already shown this one earlier. Now you see, if we want to calculate by line quantities, then VLB, ZLB will be VLB squared by base value of power in three phase. Then obviously line voltage is root 3 into phase voltage. And three phase power is 3 into single phase power. So actually 3 in numerator and denominator will be cancelled out. So we'll get whether you calculate the impedance using line quantity. Can you see the slide?
Yes,
for base impedance, then
yes,
whether you can calculate using line quantities or phase quantities, it will give you the same value. Why I am discussing this one? Say always we calculate, we take in power system, we get the voltage, power, all are in the full. Say 400 MVA system means 400 MVA line board, total power. That means line quantities. So if we can directly calculate base impedance from there, it will be easier. So you can just verify this one, that if we use line quantity, then there will be no error. Actually, it will give the same value as phase quantity, because actually impedance is a phase quantity. It is not a line quantity. But if we use the line quantity to calculate that one, we shall know, there will be no error. We are verifying that one. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So in short, impedance, if we have the permanent, the base values in terms of line quantities of voltage and total apparent power, then we can easily calculate that one. We have no need to bother to transfer it into the phase values, right? But there is problem with the current. Current is voltage, power by voltage, because VI equal to current. Here it is, there's something wrong. 1 minute. It will be VV conjugate. Can you understand this equation or not? 1 minute. It's very difficult to teach this power, this paper in online with PPT. For current will be S by V conjugate. Why? Because VI conjugate is the power. So I conjugate is power by voltage. So I will be power by voltage conjugate of that. Can you follow me?
Yes, ma'am.
So in that way, it will be S by V conjugate. Now S single phase we can write, because current will be always, you have to calculate in per phase basis. You know that for three phase system. Then current power we can write 3 into this. We can multiply numerator and denominator by 3. Why? We want to represent it by line quantities. If we could represent it by line quantities, then it would be better, like the impedance. We can directly calculate that thing. But you see, here, if we multiply numerator and denominator by 3, then it is 3 into SB 3 phase, so the SB 3 phase. Single phase, if we multiply that single phase power with 3, then the power will be converted to 3 phase power. And 3LB, 3 into PV, actually the root 3 into phase voltage equal to line voltage. So 1 root 3 will be left there. Okay. So actually power is single phase power, current is single phase power by single phase voltage conjugate. But that is not equal to three phase power by three phase voltage conjugate. There is a root 3 part. So you have to remember this root 3 part if you want to calculate current from the line quantities or from the total values. Otherwise, it is always preferred you calculate current from the single phase quantities. Or use the formula root 3 VLIL equal to the total power. From there, depending on connection, star or delta, you decide the current. Could you follow me?
Yes.
So one thing, for power, there is no problem. For impedance, there is no problem. But for current, there is a problem of root 3. So current, we shall never calculate using the line quantities. Current, we shall see the actual scenario, that then we shall calculate. Actually, we do not need to calculate current so much, but so frequently. So if we need, then we should calculate in this way, right? Okay, that's all for today. I shall send you the PPT in your common email ID. You just go through it and before the next class. Thank you. Do you have any question? Okay.